Welcome to the Landscaping Podcast. My name is Joel Barnett and I am your host. And today's episode is a special edition episode where I ask people to send in their crazy client stories. So I'm just reading out some messages that I received from people who have had a memorable experience with clients. And I'm aware that there are obviously, you know, the shoes on the other foot sometimes, and there's some crazy landscaper or designer experiences for the client. But today's episode is reading out the ones where the client is the crazy one. The first one, and they're all anonymous as well, although some of you might guess where they took place, such as this one. So this high profile couple in Auckland wanted me to supply all the plants and install for the soft landscaping job at cost, and then didn't pay the invoice until 4 months later. Life lesson: don't accept every job. Running my own landscaping business taught me a lot about people, the good, the bad, and the ugly. So that's a good one where people might have a certain persona to the public, but then when you go to work for them, you realize that everyone's just a normal person. So there's good and bad people. Next one, we have one little Italian lady that her husband was on work cover with a brain injury. She always offered us lunch, but we always said no until one day she wouldn't take no for an answer. She made us come into her house after working all day. It was around 45 degrees in her house, and she made us take our work boots off and go wash our hands. Two of us had to sit with our stinking work socks on at her dinner table across from her husband, who just smiled but didn't talk. She then proceeded to plonk the biggest bowl of ricotta pasta you have ever seen in front of both of us and wouldn't let us go back to work until we ate it. While we are sitting sweating our way through half of Italy's pasta, she then went and made a fruit platter and biscuits. I've never smelt ricotta and work socks in the same room again. And next one, we had a client's daughter that used to sunbake topless in front of us and used to ask us if she was making us uncomfortable. When we said no, she then just went and got beer. The same client once asked us to help move some furniture in the house, and there was dog poo everywhere, all over the house. I also transplanted buckets into a pot at the house and found a G-string at the bottom of the pot. That house then burnt down. So there are some wild stories that you hear. I recently built a barbecue for a client, and her and her husband specified what height they wanted it to be. I said, it's a bit higher than usual, but if that's what you want, then we will build it. So I built it, looked awesome. Everything was great. 3 days later, I get an email saying how it's too high and now it's all our fault. No responsibility taken by the owner, refusing to pay the last invoice until we rectify. I guess the client's always right. It's quite often the client is not right. But when the client has money that they're holding from you, you can either be rich or you can be right. So sometimes you're better off just to either cut your losses or just let the client have the win so that you can have your money. Next one. While sitting having lunch with the boys, I gave them a bit of a rev up just to get to the end of the job. I said, I know she's a bleepity bleep bleep, but come on, lads, together we'll just get it done. And unbeknown to me, she was sitting just above us with the window open. Never said anything, and truth be told, her attitude from that day really changed for the better. It's always awkward when the client is listening to what you're saying, especially when you're talking about them. Next one. We had an old woman who would only let us work on Saturdays because she insisted on being there. She would then make us a coffee in the kitchen every time and wouldn't let us start work until she finished her cigarette. She told us it was rude to want to leave while she was smoking. The same woman used to give us both a loaf of olive bread every week because we were vegetarian, and we later found out the pool guy and the house cleaner were getting seafood platters every week. This same woman, when she would make us coffee, she would pour herself a water from the fridge. It took a few weeks, but we slowly discovered the water was actually straight vodka, and she was pouring herself about half a liter at a time. She would then pass out while we were working and call us up later in the day to ask why we never came, even though she'd spoken to us, made us coffee, and paid us all in the morning. That is a wild story as well. And this next story, it's so crazy. I don't know if he's just taken the P155 set to see if I read it out, because it's hard to believe, but I'm reading it out anyway. I had a client with heaps of cash. I don't usually ask, but as time went on, I queried him on his income source. He told me he takes people to the quantum realm in the fifth dimension where time doesn't exist. It allows people to skip to the end of their life where they've overcome so many of life obstacles. They then take the learnings back to the current realm and expedite their personal growth. Hell of a business model. So that is one of the most unbelievable stories I've heard. The next one. We demoed a big back deck for a client. She sent me a furious message at 5 p.m. saying her dog couldn't use the doggy door and how was the dog meant to go to the toilet at night? I called her to explain the deck doesn't get rebuilt on the same day. She said this was unacceptable and asked me to come and build a dog ramp immediately. Could be controversial, but I'm a little bit team client on that one. That is, it's a difficult situation, but the dog's got to pee. And next one. Back when I was on wages working for someone, we had a client that just had his pool finished and filled. We were there finalising it. It was another bloke and I on site, and this client, when his wife would leave, would chuck his speedos on and come out and jump in the pool and keep telling us to join him. Made the site quite uncomfortable, and he was probably 50 years old. We had to decline the offer and continue working, but we did decide to finish early, and once we told the boss why, he just laughed and said, yeah, understandable. Just being friendly, that's all. All right, next one. We had a Chinese client that had a translator. Before we started the job, they wanted to sit down with us and offer us some tea. We thought we'd be polite and drink the tea. They would then fill up our cup again while we spoke to the translator. So not to be rude, we would drink the tea again. Now, after the seventh cup of tea, we were absolutely swimming in tea and couldn't handle it anymore and had to insist on no more. Turns out in Chinese culture, if you drink the tea, they'll fill it up. But if you don't want any more, you are supposed to leave it in the cup. The translator did not tell us that. We had one client who told us their daughter needed help with her garden. When we got there, we were told it was her indoor pot plants. I quickly realized it was literally to dust the leaves on the plants. Well, I didn't have anything to do that with, so I had to use my boot covers from in the ute. I'm not sure if it cleaned them or killed them, but we didn't go back. Next one. We used to look after a tiny garden in Mooney Ponds for an old retired couple. They were lovely, but always asked for a bit much. Once they asked us to clean their pots after a bug storm had splashed mud all over them. We didn't have any rags in the ute, but they offered to give us some. They then brought out two pairs of the old man Jeff's jocks. Old man tidy whities. They said, don't worry, they're clean. We awkwardly cleaned the pots and then went straight to Bunnings to buy a bag of rags to always have in the ute. The same couple also used to feed magpies and willy wagtails on their patio all the time and sent me an email telling me that they'd named their new willy wagtail after me in honor of me. It's always good to have a bag of rags in the truck. And the last one. We softscaped a big place in Croydon years ago, and the client, Pavla, was an old Eastern Ute Bloc European woman who told us she used to work for the CSIRO and used to be a competitive shot putter. After the second day of seeing us go grab lunch from the shop, she told us not to waste our money and she would make us lunch. The lunch was two slices of toast with baked beans on it and a cup of tea. She told us there is plenty of protein in beans for strong boys like us. Not only did she watch us eat it, she sat down and ate her beans on toast with us. Very, very awkward lunch and a massive game of who farted after lunch. So that was the last crazy client story. So thank you very much for everyone who sent one in. And hopefully you enjoyed Ben Scott's episode this week.